Hello friends, welcome to our Dr. Ved channel. It is our channel, veterinarian channel. I am Dr. P.R. Patel, Professor Head, Veterinary Medicine. Today we will see very important disease, a nematodal disease, endoparasitic disease called hemoncosis. Very important disease for sheep. For other ruminant also, but for sheep it is very much important. Hemoncosis in part 1, we'll study the synonyms of worm, definition of hemoncosis, etiology, life cycle and epidemiology of hemoncosis. Hemoncosis, the disease has no synonyms. Of course, local names will be there, but technically no synonym. But the worm has synonyms, hemoncus worm. It is called as stomach worm because the adult worms are found in stomach of the sheep or ruminants. It is a abomasum. There are local names, wire worm, maybe looking just like a wire, barbel pores worm, these are the local names. First, understand the disease definition. Hemoncosis is a nematodal disease and main parasite is Hemoncus contortus. Hemoncus contortus. It is important because it is the most pathogenic and voracious blood sucking parasite. Their activity is mainly blood sucking. It is a disease mainly of sheep but affect goat and cattle also. The location of this parasite is four stomachs, especially abomasum. The disease mainly causes anemia because they are blood suckers, anasarca because there is great protein loss from the body, debility, again digestive disturbance, abomasitis, loss of protein, there is progressive emaciation. Heavy worm causes abdominal pain and in acute cases when large number of the worms are invading the animal, it causes a death of the animal. Etiology. Many hemoncus species are there, but most common is Hemoncus contortus, affect mostly sheep and goat. Sheep highly susceptible. Hemoncus placi affect cattle. Hemoncus bubalis affect buffalo. Hemoncus longistips affect camel. Mostly these hemoncus are species specific, but cross infection also occurs when the small ruminants and large ruminants grazed together on the same pasture, they share the infection. So, mixed grazing of small ruminants and large ruminants, they share their infection to the small to large and large to the small. The species Hemoncus has got a very simple life cycle. You know that adult hookworms, Hemoncus, are in the abomasum. See, the adult worm are in the abomasum and they can be seen with a naked eye. The size is, length is 1 to 1.25 centimeter. It can be seen. The color is red and red-white. They are in abomasum. In abomasum, they lay eggs. they lay 10,000 eggs per day. See, it may cause a serious infection. See, number of eggs, very large numbers. Molt to first stage larva, then moves to second stage larva. We are not going into detail because you have already studied in your parasitology classes. They come out in the environment through feces. The adult worm that are in the abomasum, larval stage, come out through the feces. Then there is embryonation in the environment, development to a third stage larva. Now it is a infective and it is in the feces. This third stage larva migrate out of the fecal pellets and it is found near to the feces of the animals. This third stage larva move near about the feces. The movement of third stage larva is more in hot humid climate. Remember, very important climate for worms. Hot humid climate, they decide the disease. The dry and cold climate is unfavorable for the larva. There is ingestion of this larva by ruminants during grazing. They remove the cyst, ex-cyst mat in the rumen. After grazing, they eat to the rumen, ex-cyst mat, and there is emergence of fourth stage larva. This fourth stage larva affect the abomasal gland. They very well enter into the gland and slowly they develop into the adult womb. This adult male and adult female copulate, unite, and they lay eggs. And this time require about 3 weeks. This is about the life cycle. Very simple and easy life cycle. Epidemiology. Disease is very much important because worldwide distribution, it is present in all countries. Where the ships are there, more number of cases. But this disease is more prevalent in tropical, hot, humid region or hot, humid countries. Summer, hot, rainy season, humid, hot, humid region, because that is favorable for the worm. We have already seen in the life cycle. And this type of hot humid regions are found in our northern part of the India. In northern part of India, there is hot humid climate also. At the same time, more number of sheep also. Other animals are also there, but mostly sheep are affected. So in northern part of India, sheep population is more, so disease also more. Hot humid climate. The sheep, especially the young lambs and yearlings about a year, are highly susceptible and it causes a great economic loss because these young lambs become adult tomorrow. They give a wool, milk, mutton, everything. In the goat, there is no discretion about the age. All ages are susceptible. But in cattle, the calves up to 2 to 3 years are susceptible. Young calves, 2 to 3 years, the heifer are susceptible. There are certain predisposing factors which invite the disease. One is the malnutrition. If the nutrition is not proper, protein, fat, vitamins, minerals, etc. Overcrowding. Overcrowding is a great stress to the sheep At the same time, the ship come in contact with each other very greatly. So more spread of the disease, overcrowding. Less green pasture. It is good for both, for the sheep as well as for the parasite. Less green pasture is good for the parasite, also for their protection. Less green pasture is also an attraction for the lamb. They graze. They like to graze. Warm, humid climate is good for the parasite. These are the predisposing factors which increases the incidences and prevalence of the disease. The hemoncosis is of very great economic importance and it causes greatest economic losses in the sheep. It is the main disease of the sheep, main parasitic disease of the sheep, causing gastroenteritis. When you study gastroenteritis, remember this hemoncosis, especially in yearling lambs. It is observed by the scientists that in goats, the Trypanosoma congolis infection increases the susceptibility to the hemoncosis. That is their observation. So like this, if any other disease is there, it causes decrease in vitality of the animal and may invite the disease. Spring is nothing a spring-like. It is a season. Spring is a season, just like rainfall, hot humid climate. Rise means rise of the worm. A rise of worm. Large number of worms during spring season, it is called as spring lice. The sheep with heavy infestation generally occur in the rainy season. It is a part of a spring season. And they lay large number of eggs on the pasture. There is a high level of third stage larva in pasture. The sheep ingest these larvae while grazing on the pasture. And there is high population of adult hemoncus in late spring and summer. This is spring rice. During this time, there is large number of the worms, the larvae and adult are found because there is hot humid climate. It is called as spring rice. This season is very important for us because during this season we have to protect the sheep from larva and adult. So spring rice is important. Friends, share this information to all veterinarians. It is important for the field purpose. It is important for the examination purpose. It is important for the sheep industry. It is important for the owner. So it is important for you also. Don't forget to share this thing to veterinarians. Requested to subscribe this channel if you want the progress of this channel. Thank you very much for observing this video.